So now in today's session, we are going to discuss about servlet config. What is that? Servlet config interface. Which interface, sir?
Servlet config.
So what is this? Actually, it is an interface available in which package? javax.servlet.star package. That is first thing. Second one. So it has all these methods, the very important methods of servlet config interface. The first one, when you look at this, get init parameter. It is used to read the initialization parameters, Ms. Corey. Okay, first one is this get init parameter, which returns a string. Means generally, you know, the purpose of servlet config is let me explain this another point. It is used to store what details, Mr. Gauri?
Servlet web containers.
Configuration details from web.xml file. Which file?
Web.xml.
I'm going to show you with practical example what are the configuration details and how to read that web.xml files. And these configuration details which are declared in this web.xml file, we call them as initialization parameters. What parameters, sir?
Initialization.
Yes, we can read that. Of course, not just only that, it also has the complete servlet information. Which information?
Servlet.
You know, right? Something we declare in that servlet tag. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Servlet name, servlet class, and the initialization parameters, everything. We call them as configuration details. And that details we can store into this servlet config object. Do you understand that now?
Yes, sir.
Maybe you can ask me a question. This is an interface. How can we create an object for this, sir? That will be taken care by the container. We don't need to care about that. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Might be there will be some implementation classes provided in the internal thing, okay, in the implementation, and it uses something for that, okay? Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Now, actually, in this servlet config interface, we have all these methods, get init parameter, which is used to read the initialization parameters from servlet config object. Anyhow, I will show you a practical example how to read this initialization parameters, because this is very important for us to understand, okay? And another one, get init parameter names. Instead of reading each parameter, that we can read all parameters at a time using this method in the form of enumeration. Can you see? This returns all the details in the form of enumeration. That is one thing. That is an iterator. We had discussed that in core Java, which iterates all the values object by object. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Get servlet name. It returns the name of the servlet which you are trying to declare in the configuration file. Okay. And finally, get servlet context. Of course, this has a method which returns context object. Might be we'll talk about context after this. What is servlet context and why do we need that? All that. Yes, do you understand this, Ms. Gauri?
Yes, sir.
That's about servlet config. Got it now?
Yes, sir.
So what is servlet config? It's used to store configuration details of servlet, which are declared in the web.xml file or which are declared with web servlet annotation. Which annotation?
Web servlet.
Web servlet annotation. That is one thing. Second thing is it has these methods which are very important. Get init parameter is used to read initialization parameters one by one. Init parameter names, this method reads all the parameters at a time in the form of enumeration. Get servlet name will return the name of the servlet, and this returns servlet context object. We'll talk about it in the next after this session, okay, after this topic. Now let us see this now. First thing is when I talk about servlet config, the first question I would like to ask is how to get servlet config object? That is the first question. So if you want to read configuration details, the first thing is how to get a servlet configure object. Do you understand this now?
Yes, sir.
So this is so simple. So if you want to get this servlet config object, then inside this servlet request interface, which interface, sir?
Servlet request.
There is a method called get a servlet config. Also, this is there in servlet interface also. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
And even you can find that in generic servlet, inherited to generic servlet. Do you get that point? Huh?
Yes, sir.
So, the purpose of this method is it returns servlet config object. Which object?
Servlet config.
And this return servlet config object, now we initialize that to that reference of servlet interface, servlet config interface. Something like this, servlet config space some config equal to
request dot.
Request dot. What is that?
Request dot get servlet.
Request dot get servlet config. That is one thing. Otherwise, you can directly say get servlet config also. Why?
Servlet config.
This method is inherited from servlet interface. Which interface, sir?
Servlet interface.
And it is overridden in generic servlet. Which
generic.
And the same thing is inherited to HTTP servlet also. So we can get servlet config object in two ways by using this method, get servlet config. And this method returns config object. And we can call it directly like this. Or otherwise you can say request. Even this is present in request interface also. Servlet request interface. Which interface, sir?
Servlet request interface.
Request dot get servlet config. You can even you can get with from request object. Do you understand that now?
Yes, sir.
Servlet request interface. We can invoke this. Call it right?
Yes, sir.
So that's it, Ms. Kauri. That is number one. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
So that is one thing. Now the question is, you know, we had already discussed the purpose of servlet config is to, what is that? Store configuration details, including initialization parameters. What parameters, sir?
Initialization.
Now the question is, how to get initialization parameters? And might be you can ask me a question, what is an initialization parameter? Actually, this is one more very important thing to understand. Initialization parameters are nothing but initialization parameters are key value pairs. What is that, Ms. Gauri?
Key value pairs.
Key value pairs declared in web.xml file or with the at the rate web servlet annotation. Which annotation?
Web servlet annotation. Okay, whatever we provide in the form as action.
Exactly. So even we can declare these initialization parameters either with inside web.xml or with this annotation. You can choose any one there, not both. You got the point, right?
Yes, sir.
Because both are not necessary. Do you understand it?
Yes, sir.
If you are using annotation, then it's not necessary to use XML. If you are using XML, then it's not necessary to use annotation.
Yes, sir.
And these are key value pairs generally used to declare in web.xml or this annotation. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
And the purpose of initialization parameters is it is used to provide certain information about some mail information or admin information. Or some kind of information like this. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
So that's it. Got it right? So next one. So next the question is how to get initialization parameters. What is that?
Initialization
parameters. And the syntax look like this, Ms. Gauri. To get initialization parameter, we have to use a method get init parameter, which has a parameter as a string, and this method is available in which interface?
Request.
In servlet request interface. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, this is in servlet config, this code.
Oh, okay, sir.
This is in servlet config interface. I just told you this about the methods of servlet config. You can see it has four, the important methods. I had listed all the important methods, and get init parameter is one such method in servlet config interface. Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Do you look at this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, where this is present, inside which interface, sir?
Servlet config.
You told me servlet request, okay?
Okay, sir.
Servlet request has this method, get servlet config, Miss Gauri.
Okay, sir.
You got it right?
Yes, sir.
And the syntax look like this. How to get this initialization parameter? Some string str equal to some config. You have to invoke this using config reference. Which reference, Miss Gauri?
Config.
Because this method is present in config object, and this is instance method, and we invoke that using reference of config. Config dot get init parameter, and here you have to provide the key name, which is a string of things. What is that, Miss Gauri?
Key name.
The key name, which is a string actually, and the value associated with this key is returned to this string. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I hope this is clear to you, Miss Gauri.
Yes, sir.
Any questions so far? And is it perfect to you now?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting any idea about this servlet configuration details? I mean, this init parameters, all that?
Yes, sir.
Now, let's see a practical example to understand this config object and initialization parameters, all that. Are you ready for that, Miss Gauri?
Yes, sir.
Let's see this now. Are you writing all this? Making a note of all this?
Yes, sir. 1 second, sir.
1 second. Would be enough for you? Do you think it's sufficient?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, can you show the notepad?
Yeah. Yep, yep. So copy all this. Now what we will do here is, let's do an application on this, Ms. Gauri. Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Let's do one thing. Create a new project. Otherwise, you can go with this project already we had done. Okay, we'll start from scratch, okay? File, new.
New dynamic project.
We should choose which project? Dynamic web project. Choose some web here. Expand that. Dynamic web project, next. And then just give this as a servlet config project, and then new runtime. Might be in my machine, I have 1.7, so choose that, okay? And the path is auto selected here. Can you see this now?
Yes, sir.
I think I don't need to select. I hope I had already, this is configured here, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Can you see this? Okay. Next. I'm adding web.xml because this is necessary for me, and click on finish. And say yes. This time I am trying to declare initialization parameters with what is that?
Web.fm in mobile.
Okay. And before that, first thing is, let's go to web.xml. And now what is that you have to do is, you don't need all this actually. If you want, you can remove this, Ms. Gauri. Now here, what is that is, you should have to declare servlet tag here. What tag?
Servlet.
Remove this. This were not necessary actually. You can remove this. Welcome list, all that I'll tell about. I'll explain them. Now inside servlet tag, you should have, what is that, servlet name. And just give the name as, servlet name as, what is that, config servlet. What servlet?
Config.
Servlet
class.
One more tag. Servlet class. And you just name this fully qualified name, com.manohar.. Because of course, if I do like this, it'll be a bit confused here. Okay, I'll do one thing. First, let me create a servlet, okay? That's better. Before going to create web.xml, do one thing. Let's create servlet, okay?
SRC.
First, you do one thing. I am again reverting back all the changes. Let's come from these steps, okay? first create servlet and then go for creating web.xml. That would be fine, okay?
Yes, sir.
Go to SRC, right click, new
servlet.
Servlet. Of course, one thing, first create package. Com dot
Manohar
dot servlets. Enter. Now on that create, what is that?
Servlet.
Now in that package, add servlet. And name the servlet as a servlet config. Okay, servlet. Otherwise, name it as some test servlet. What servlet?
Test servlet.
That will be fine for us. And change this to generic servlet here. What servlet? The super class. You change it to generic servlet. You know the package name. Actually, generic servlet is part of Java X.servlet package. So choose that. And the name of servlet is test servlet. That's fine. And then click on next. And then click on next. And just service is enough for us. Click on finish. Now we are done with this. And you don't need to implement servlet interface if you are extending generic servlet. Because already generic servlet implements servlet interface. Which implements servlet interface, sir?
Generic servlet.
And you don't need all this. I hope you can.
You just click the minus sign beside, sir.
Pardon?
On the minus sign beside line 18, sir.
This one?
Yes, sir.
So, okay.
Others, what all you don't need, you can remove it later.
No. It will just minimize. That's it. When you say something, just cut, minimize. That's it.
Yes, sir.
Got it, right? Something like this. Do you understand now?
Yes, sir.
So this is your class and you need service now. Now we write some code here. We'll come to this point again, okay? You understand this now?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is your servlet. We'll talk about this code again because this application is to test or to display configuration details of servlet. Do you understand that now?
Yes, sir.
If you want to display configuration details, you know very well. The configuration details are stored in which object?
Servlet config.
Servlet config. Anyhow, I'll explain that with a detailed analysis. Trust me. So now you don't need all this bullshit in this web.xml. Remove that. And first thing is, you know how to configure servlets, right?
Yes, sir.
So you need which tag now? A servlet tag inside that. Now again inside that servlet name, and you go just name it as test itself. Again inside that servlet class, and now you name that com dot Manohar dot, and then it's servlets.
So you're putting the package name, sir?
Fully qualified name. Yes, exactly. Without that, it don't work. And finally, just specify test servlet. This is how people configure servlet in real time, Ms. Kauri.
Okay, sir.
Now after that, once you are done with servlet, you have to declare one more tag. It should be servlet mapping. Inside that, you should declare again servlet name. You copy this and you paste it here. And then now you have to far. And the final thing is URL pattern. And just say
slash servlet.
Slash, just give it as servlet name itself as URL pattern. So that it's easy for you to remember, okay? The class name will be URL pattern, okay? Both. It's easy for us.
So whatever is specified in at web address, we can't put that as URL?
Actually, you can name as you like. It's not necessary to provide test servlet here. You can put ABC, XYZ. Some kind of URL is required here. Some pattern is required. Got it, right?
Okay, sir.
It's not like you should put test servlet here. You can put some pattern like something like ABC or something like test. Okay? Do you understand that, Ms. Kauri?
Yes.
Something like that, okay. But make it as test servlet. It's not that we should give the URL pattern same name as class name. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
It's your wish. You can name as you like as per the requirement. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Now, what I want to do is, Gauri, this is one thing. So I had explained the execution flow of generic servlet, right?
Yes, sir.
So, you know, the thing is here, three objects are created by default. Of course, four objects. But so far, I am exposing only three so far. The other one will talk after this, okay?
Yes, sir.
So that is servlet config, servlet request, servlet response, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So when you run the servlet application, first thing what happens is your container will read web.xml file. Which file?
Web.xml.
And from web.xml file, these are configuration details. This, whatever you have declared here, these are configuration details. You got it right?
Okay, same like form, no, sir?
Yeah, these are configuration details. And these details are loaded into servlet config object. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Container will read these details, servlet details. Of course, this not mapping details, this servlet details. And put this servlet details into config object. Which object?
Config.
Suppose this is for one servlet. You ask, so far we have created only one servlet, right?
Yes, sir.
Suppose you created two servlets. Then you should declare two servlets with the another one more servlet tag and servlet mapping.
Yes, sir.
Suppose you have 10 servlets, then you need 10 servlet tags and 10 servlet mappings. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Means for each servlet, you need one servlet tag and one servlet mapping.
Okay, sir.
And similarly, and for each servlet, you have one servlet config object. One more important point. What is that?
Servlet one config object.
For each servlet, one servlet config object. Which object?
Servlet config object.
Config object. For 10 servlets?
10 servlet config object.
10 servlet config objects are created. How many objects are created?
10 servlet config
objects. I hope you got clarity here.
Yes, sir.
Every object has one servlet. Every servlet config has one servlet details. Do you understand that, Ms. Gauri?
Yes, sir.
And these are stored in the form of key value pairs again. How these values are stored?
Key value pairs.
As usual, I told you, right? Like yes, in servlet request object, okay?
Yes,
so this is one more important point, very important point. Remember this, Gauri, okay? Might be useful for bits. Next one. But I hope this is clear. And apart from that, I want to declare initialization parameters. What parameters, sir?
Initialization.
That you have to declare inside a servlet tag. Which tag?
Servlet.
With the tag called init param. What is the tag name here?
Init param.
As name says, what is init param?
Parameter of the init.
Initialization parameters. What parameters, sir?
Initialization parameter.
And for each servlet, we can declare separate initialization parameters. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
Like, you know, connecting to databases. That JDBC details we can provide in this init as init parameters. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
Database connection details, that is a database username, password, all that is there, right? That you can declare here, okay?
Okay.
And for each servlet, we can provide initialization parameters separately. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
Suppose one more servlet, we can provide one more init parameter for that.
Okay.
So we can have separate initialization parameters for each servlet. You got this point?
Yes, sir.
So now inside this, you need to provide, what is that? A key value pairs. Param name. Suppose you take it as some email. And then next one, param value. Suppose I am just giving it as something like manohar.vedatri@ what is that? gmail.com. Do you understand this now?
Yes, sir.
Of course, do one thing. You remove this initialization parameters here and you put them at the end of this, okay? Generally, we have to declare initialization parameters at the bottom of servlet tag. Where should we declare that?
Bottom of servlet.
After declaring servlet class. You understand that?
Okay. Any order is fine, no, sir? It checks that also?
No. You cannot declare them. You see this now. As I had declared this initialization parameters at the beginning, you see this. Can you see this now? You know why this error? Because Because, you know, Ms. Gauri, this initialization parameters are loaded or configuration details are loaded only after creating object for servlet.
Okay. Yes, sir.
You got it right?
Yes, sir.
Once a servlet object is created, then all these objects are created. Associated objects.
Yes, sir.
Means it has to be loaded, it has to be instantiated. Then when init method is called, then at the time of creating servlet config object, all these initialization parameters, servlet details are injected to that servlet config object.
Okay.
You understand that now?
Yes, sir.
So that's why if you declare them in the beginning itself, then container cannot read them. And it doesn't know where to put these initialization parameters. Because by that time object is ready.
Yes, sir.
Do you think that object is ready by that time, Ms. Gauri?
No, sir.
No. Because infrastructure is not ready to load this initialization parameters.
Got okay.
It? See, you can have a tea in your cup only when, cups are available. Got it okay. Right?
Yes, sir.
Suppose I came to your house, Gauri. You need to serve me a tea.
Yes,
then
sir.
You need incense. Generally, that's a, what is a, it's a, what do you call that? Part of some kind of this thing, you give some tea. If you want to give tea, what is that you should do?
Get the cup.
First, cups must be ready, then you put tea.
Yes, sir.
So here also, first that servlet config object must exist before you load this parameter. That's why you have to declare these parameters after servlet tag, okay? Servlet class tag. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
So that's it. So now, we are done now. Enough. In this way, suppose you want one more key value pair, one more this thing, init parameter. So if you want one more key value pair, one more init parameter. In this way, how many other key value pairs you want, that many init param tags you have to declare inside servlet tag. Which tag there?
Inside servlet.
So we are done now. Enough. One is enough for us. The same thing you can do for any number of parameters. Now go to servlet. Now, actually, you know, this, all the details from web.xml are loaded into which object?
Servlet config.
So first get servlet config object. So step one here, get servlet config. So first thing, how do you do that? Servlet. Now in the service method, create servlet config object. Servlet config space.
Config is equal to.
Config equal to. Here we have to say request dot get
servlet config.
Get servlet name is available, but okay. In this request object, you don't have config object. I think we have to make a small correction here, Gauri.
Yes,
I think I had given some, in fact, it's the wrong information.
Yes.
I'm sorry. This servlet config method is not present in which interface?
Get request.
So please don't. You can. I told you two ways, but it's only one way. What is that? Directly call it from?
Get servlet config.
Get directly call this method. No need of using any reference. Please remove this reference. That is small correction. Get servlet config. Now you got this right?
Yes, sir.
And this method is implemented in generic servlet interface. Which interface? I'm sorry, generic servlet class. Which class?
Generic servlet.
Now this get servlet config will return servlet config object.
Yes.
But that is initial. Now you can invoke initialization parameters. How? String email equal to, you know, right? How to read initialization parameters, sir?
Yes, sir.
Get init parameter of, what is the name of the key you have declared in this init param? Key is email, value is this one.
Mm-hmm.
You understand this now?
Yes, sir.
Now you have to get provide that that thing here. Save this and pass here. What is that email? And this variable name need not to be email. Okay. I just took this like that. Okay. But you can put any variable name here. Okay.
Yes, sir. Both are same also, no problem.
This is from, this must be the same. this must be same as this key name, okay? No change at all. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
You can copy this and put here. But this can be anything. This is a local variable. It can be anything, okay?
Okay, sir.
Now display this email onto browser. Now you have run, you have read this initialization parameter. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
Now, first get this print writer object to display this onto browser. Print writer space sum out equal to what is that? Then what is that? Out dot. Print off. What is that?
Email.
The email is, of course, you can put that with heading tag also, if you in HTML tag also, okay?
Yes.
And just include that to the text. And finally,
out.close.
Out.close. Okay, save this. Shall I run this code now?
Yes, sir.
Now go to your project here. We are done actually. So now you got clarity now?
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose I am displaying initialization parameters. But these are available with the which object? Servlet config. If you want, you can invoke the servlet name also, Gauri. What name?
Servlet name.
Suppose I want to print servlet name also. Then how can I do that? It's simple. To get servlet name, again we have to declare one more variable here. What is that? String name equal to config dot. Even config interface has this method. What is that method?
Get servlet name.
Then you can just print that onto browser if you want. Again,
request and even config, sir.
Yeah, both has servlet name. Okay.
Both give the same value.
Obviously, no big difference. Name. Certain methods are common for different interfaces. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now we are done actually. So we got servlet name, we got servlet initialization parameters. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's it. Now are you ready to print it?
Yes, sir.
Now you do one thing. Select your project, right click. And you know one thing? Plus disable this web servlet. Which servlet?
Web servlet.
Because already I had declared all the configuration details were inside.
Web.xml.
Then I told you clearly, if we are declaring using web.xml, don't declare, don't use this annotation, not necessary, okay?
Yes, sir.
So now what do you do right now? Run this application, select your project, right click, run as, run on server, finish, restart server, server restarted, and browser is invoked, and here pass the URL. What is the URL now?
Test servlet.
Test servlet. Servlet. S-E-R-V-L-E-T. Enter. I think I got an error here. That's really awesome. Class not found exception. Might be some spelling mistake. com.monohar.servlets. Yeah, you can go and check this web.xml. Here it is S-E-R-V-L-E-T-S. What is that?
L-E-T-S.
But I had, that is a spelling mistake. Now that's not a, what is that? International problem. Okay. We can just rerun this again and restart server for one more time. This time we are going to get a perfect output. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Then here just type it as test the servlet. S-E-R-V. L-E-T. Enter. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
This is test. This is name of your servlet. Can you see? This is what I had given in web.xml, right? Is this test or not?
Okay, sir.
The second one, the mail is this. Do you understand us now?
Okay.
Suppose you want to display line by line. Then you have to make a small, you have to add a break tag here. In double quotes one more time. What is that? Put a break tag. We don't use ln here. Of course, otherwise print ln. What is that you should use? Sir?
Print ln.
Either use ln here or put break tag. Do you understand that now?
Yes, sir.
Now you can run it for one more time just to test the output. Right click, run as, run on server, finish this. Okay. Yes. Yes. And then pass here. What is that? Miss Gauri URL test servlet. Now you got it right. The email is test. And then of course you should change this in the test servlet. What is that? instead of the email, you can say the servlet name is, put some space here, put some space here, everything is fine. Now you can rerun this one more time for better output. What is that? Right click, run as. Okay, right click, run as, run on server, finish it. Okay, this is the last run. Okay, Miss Gauri.
Yes, sir.
And name this as, what is that here? Test servlet enter. Do you get this now? The servlet name is test and the email is manohar.vidatri@gmail.com.
Yes, sir.
You understand this now?
Yes, sir.
That's it, Gauri. This is about, now this is a clear proof that servlet config has all these details, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Because you are able to get the name of servlet, you are able to get initialization parameters of servlet. All this is possible because of which object?
Servlet config.
It's clearly proved that servlet config has configuration details of servlet, which are loaded from which file?
Web.xml.
Web.xml file. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Might be you can try to get, let me check if we can get any other names here. Context object, we use it after this. Config dot get class will return this class name internally, okay?
Yes, sir.
But that is a total different story. We don't need that, okay? You got it right there?
Yes, sir.
Through reflection, you can get that servlet class name also. That is test servlet. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Gauri?
Yes, sir.
So that's it about servlet config. So hope, let me quickly summarize about config here. What is that first thing? It is just to, I hope it's clearly explained now. It is just store what details?
Servlet configuration details.
Configuration details of servlet. That is one thing. Then it has it is in javax.servlet.star package. Generally, configuration details are provided in web.xml or web servlet annotation. It has all these important methods. Get init parameter, usually used to read initialization parameters. This is used to read all the parameters at a time. Get servlet name returns the name of the servlet. Get servlet context returns the context object. That we talk about context after this, maybe in tomorrow's session.
Yes.
And suppose, how do you get servlet config object? We can directly call this method get servlet config. You know, this is part of servlet interface, which is inherited to generic servlet. We call it directly. That will return config object, which should be initialized to that reference of servlet config. Now that next point, this is an interface, of course. How to get initialization parameters? Initialization parameters means they are nothing but key value pairs declared in web.xml, or we can declare with a web servlet annotation also. And the method signature looks like this. And you can call that method using config reference, because this is part of that object. And you have to pass your key name, which is a string declared in web.xml. And this method returns a string value that is initialized to string variable. And generally, each servlet config object stores one servlet details. Suppose if I have 10 servlet subtarlets, then 10 servlet config objects are created by web container. So number of servlets is equal to number of servlet config objects. You got it right? Might be you can assume config like this, Gauri. It's like a book with a student. Suppose there are 10 students in a class. Every student has his own book, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And what do you do? Something like that. Means, sir, 10 students, 10 books. That's servlet config. Got it right?
Yes, sir.
And you know, every student, suppose a teacher is teaching something. Every student writes, sir, his or her own details in that book, okay?
Yes, sir.
That's it. That's the something which is easy to understand. Okay. You got it right?
Yes, sir.
So that's all about servlet config. What is servlet config? All that. Maybe tomorrow I will explain the diagrammatic analysis of this once, and we go for what is that? Servlet context. Hope this is clear.
Now you can.